Hi there, and welcome to this little video about how to shoot in manual mode on a Sony RX100. This little handy thing. This is a Mark III, as you can see here. You can get them up to Mark VI, I believe, nowadays. But I bought this one because it was fantastic value, I think, for the price I paid. And I didn't need all the more modern features like 4K and the like. So here we are. And as you probably already know, you press this little button to switch on the camera. And in manual mode, you select manual mode here on the mode dial, just like you would basically any other mode. And here in the top left, you can see the camera confirms that you are now in manual mode with a little M, obviously. So you need to control three things in manual mode. And the first up is the aperture. And aperture, you can see the reading down here, the current value. But if you turn the ring here on the front of the camera, you know, this one here, you can turn that and change the aperture. And as you can see here, it's showing me now I'm at 1.8, which is the the lowest f-stop number. And when we're going to go all the way up to, I believe it's 22 or thereabout. No, it wasn't, it was 11. But you can see it shows me the, in red, it shows me the value I've chosen. And in white, it shows me the options right next to that, both upwards and downwards direction. So let's choose here F5, and that's it. And you can see it remains here in the bottom of the screen. Second up is the shutter speed. And you can select the shutter speed just by dialing or turning this little dial here, command dial, I think it's called. And you can see here again in red, bottom left, it is changing the shutter speed. Now I'm at 1/10, 1/8, and so on and so forth. So that's pretty easy to change. And if you want to change it all the way, I believe 1/30 seconds is the slowest it can go as a default value or standard value. But if you go one more, it goes bulb. And that means that the sensor will be exposed to light as long as you keep the shutter down. As soon as you release it again, then it closes again. So that's very useful for doing long exposures or exposures where you need some other values than these values I'm showing you here. The camera will go, the fastest it will go, I'm just turning here to show you, go to 1/2000th of a second, and that is basically the fastest it can do. The last thing to control, other of course than focus and hence sharpness, that is the ISO. And ISO, you can access that by pressing the little function button here. This may be difficult to see, but it says FN, and I think it's abbreviation for function. If you press that one, you get this little menu here. You can see there are two rows of values to choose from. If you then press left or right, you can see I can walk around this little menu system to my liking. And it will open, if I press it again, it will close the menu. If I open here again, it will start where I left. So if you are at ISO down here and you close the menu, it will open that again. So it's quite nice because it then knows that where you left off. And if you often use the ISO, you can just leave it there and it's ready to be used. You can select the value just pressing the center of the button here. And then you get this little table you can scroll up and down in. In the very top, you have auto ISO. That's for the lazy, or if you don't want to worry about that value, but then it almost becomes a semi-automatic mode. And then you have the lowest ISO, which is 80. And then you can go all the way up to, I think it's 12,000, was it 600 or 800, there about a lot you can see here. I would say be careful going above 1600, but you can of course make your own experience. But I would say you get grainy pictures if you go above that value. Let me also show you here that if you press the function button, then and it starts on ISO here, you can then just turn this command dial over here, and then you can select it without pressing the center of the button again. That's one way of doing it. And then maybe the easiest way of doing it is when you have pressed the function button, you can turn the ring on the front that we used to change the aperture before, and now it changes the ISO. I think this is really a nice feature with the Sony camera. Unfortunately, the manual does not give much of this away, but you can figure this out by working a little bit with the camera. But it really is actually quite user-friendly in that sense, provided that there are no dedicated buttons for setting the ISO. I think this works fine. And then finally, I just wanted to show you here, as you change, now I'm changing the shutter speed, you can see in the bottom left, as you can see that, it immediately shows me the effect of that in a lighter or a darker picture. And that's one of the great things with the mirrorless compared to DSLRs, that you can actually see the effect of what you're shooting before it happens. So you can see now F11 and a shutter speed of, let's say, a 500th of a second. That probably gives me a very dark picture. So no need to push the shutter there. I can see that I need to adjust the values here. This is better, right? Okay, and that's it. Actually, those are the three parameters you need to control. And if you want to dive more into this, I have a little blog where I have written how to control your camera like this one in manual mode. And I will post a link to that below this video. Otherwise, thank you for watching. Take care. Bye-bye.